Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Top question that I get from non-Muslims. Do you get hot wearing that? Top questions I get from Muslim sisters. Does your husband make you wear it? Are you a revert? Do you not know that it's not fard to wear the niqab? Aren't you scared? Aren't you worried about your safety walking around like that? Top question I get from non-Muslims. Do you get hot? What is this? What are you guys really trying to do to me? I'm not understanding. Why is it that when these Muslim sisters and brothers try to fill us up with all of these fearful words about the dangers of being a Muslim and doing anything that's completely normal, or the dangers of being a Muslim and actually practicing our deen, right? Why is it that you guys are trying to spread all constantly this negativity? And then using these news clips or whatever it is that you wanna use as your proof to me as to why I'm supposed to stop living my life according to Quran and Sunnah, and I'm supposed to do what exactly? What do you want from me? And why is your opinion important when you are choosing to take the opinion of something else over the Quran and Sunnah? You're choosing to, I don't know, try to make people feel comfortable because they're not uncomfortable anyway. If you just go and talk and act like a normal person, people will approach you and they will talk to you and they will ask questions that they really want to know. So I'm really not sure why you guys think that is gonna be helpful to you to try to disassociate yourself from looking like a Muslim or acting like a Muslim, and don't say Allahu Akbar and don't dress like this. Look at it. The only people mentioning things like, oh, people didn't call the cops on you guys. People didn't think you guys were terrorists. Why? For doing completely normal things that I did before I was a Muslim, and now I'm not supposed to do things anymore because I'm a Muslim? I just want you guys to know right now, y'all are delusioned. Y'all have issues, okay? Serious, serious issues. And if I wasn't your sister and I didn't love you, I wouldn't tell you. I would just let you guys continue walking around and making yourselves mentally sick. You guys are the ones who is helping to spread this negativity in the community, all right? If you see a Muslim sister happy, walking around happy and confident in her hijab or her niqab, shut your mouth. If you're not a woman who's confident enough to wear your hijab outside, you're not confident enough to go out as a Muslim and do regular things everybody else does, you're mental. Nobody told you you can't do stuff, but you just decide that you can't do things because you're scared of what other people are gonna think about you. Try being normal. Try acting like a normal citizen in the country where you live in, and deal with your neighbors in a normal way, like you are supposed to deal with them. And you will find that a lot of those things that you guys are so scared about, it's all inside of your head, because these people, they have lives, they have families, they have children, they have jobs, and they've got problems up to here, problems up to there. They're not thinking about you all day, how much they hate Muslims and how much they want to kill everybody. That's just not the thing going on. Yes, there may be some crazy folks out there, but that's just not everybody, nor is it the majority of people, nor is it even a large portion of people. Even if they don't like you, even if they have problems with you, even if they don't agree with your religious beliefs, they have their own lives and their own things to do. So I just want to tell you guys that Allah will show you guys in the future if what I'm saying is true or false. But if you really think that everybody walking on the street is angry enough about what I'm wearing to catch 25 to life. Anyway, guys, dude, I'm getting more pressure from the Muslim community to not be myself than I am from the non-Muslim community. And that's insane to me. That's really insane. Anyway, assalamu alaikum, and you guys have a wonderful day.
My Lord, I believe, so I pray you guide me on your path to something beautiful, something beautiful, just like a dream, every morning when I wake up.